What's up, everyone, and welcome back to the channel. My name is Richard, and this is Slasher and Collectibles. Today, we're going to be taking a look at the 6-scale Daredevil figure by Hot Toys. Let's take a quick look at the product page before we actually jump into the review. I always like to kind of look at these and just kind of see where they used to be compared to where they are now. So if you look at the Daredevil figure, when it first released, we're looking at a price point of $229.99. The figure looks absolutely great. It comes with this dynamic base right here, which looks awesome. The figure, the suit looks awesome. You also get the batons down here. Overall, I think through the product page and these images, the figure looks phenomenal, and I can't wait to get into the unboxing to kind of see what he actually looks like. Take a look at what price points are now. We remember it was $229 when it was first released. So these are I'm gonna take a look at the eBay sold listings. So here we have a first sold at $445. You have around $490, $499. This one is $225. This person actually got a phenomenal deal on it. I'm kind of curious to look at this after I get off the video to kind of see if this one is real. But that is a phenomenal deal if they got it for that price. You have another one for $600. You have one for $494. So we're looking at a price around $499 is going to be the average on where you're going to be able to pick this up. I do see it a little bit more for some of the other figures. But if you're looking for a used or new figure, you're looking around $499. So let's go ahead and jump right into the review and we'll take a look at the figure. Alright, so here is the box for the Daredevil figure. As you can see, it has a black and red color gradient, which works great for the character. Coolest part of this box right here is that you actually have Daredevil written in Braille. You can actually put your finger over this and actually feel it. It is raised up from the box. You also get an image of Daredevil right here on the front of the box. And then the color gradient, the black and the red, also continue through both sides. If you flip it over to the side, you have the Daredevil logo right here, as well as the Braille again written here at the bottom. And then same thing for the other side. You have Daredevil and Braille written right back here. You flip it over to the back, you have all the legal information, and then you also have the color gradient with the black and the red continuing here on the back as well. This is a slip style cover box with a window, so if you go ahead and pull that off, you can see the character right here laid out right with that cutout window. So I'm going to go ahead and get this figure unboxed, and then we'll take a look at the accessories and the figure. All right, as you guys can see, he doesn't come with very many accessories, but the ones that he does come with are extremely crucial to the actual figure, so I'm okay with what it comes with. So let's go ahead and jump right in. The first thing we're going to take a look at is the hands. You can see you do get three pairs of hands. The first hand we're going to take a look at is a closed fist hand. So this is if you want to have him in like a fighting pose or some kind of stance just with a closed fist. You do have the outfit on him that kind of continues throughout the glove as well with the red and the black. And then you also get some sculpted textures right in on the bottom of the glove there. The other ones that you come with are the grip hands. The grip hands are currently on the figure. This is going to hold the batons or the billy clubs, however you want to call them. And then you also get a set of open grip hands. As for the weapons, you get three sets of batons or billy clubs. So the first one that we're going to be taking a look at is the full connected version. So this one is if you want to have them all connected together. You can see it has some textures there at the bottom of the billy club, going from like a purplish brownish color up into this silver paint applications right there. You also get a disconnected version if you want to have them in the grip hands. Let's take a closer look at some of that sculpted detail in there. And then the last one you get is the nunchuck style. So you do have this wire right here that is connected. Let me get that to focus. So you have the wire that's connected between both of them, kind of like the separated ones, except that you have the wire to connect both of them to get some cool dynamic poses out of it. There's not very much difference between the three, except you get one that's attached, one that's detached, and then the one with the wire. So you also get a dynamic base with it. So here, let's go ahead and take a first look at the base here. So the bricks look great. You have some pretty good sculpting in here with some great paint applications. As you can see, there's also some bricks laying around here with some broken glass This look is a diorama for like a rooftop, so you also have these posts that are coming out here. Great paint applications. You have some edges here that are broken off, and you have some of this silver going up to this almost goldish color right here to get some differentiation between the different colors. You also get this black piece right here. This piece actually just sits right on top of it. So when you have them displayed with this, you have this rooftop type style right here. So you got the Daredevil logo with the cityscape behind it. So if you want to use the diorama base, you just set it on that black piece. You connect this right here, and then you have that hidden from behind it, and you can just have this rooftop sitting right on top of there. Then the last thing I want to take a look at that it also comes with is this, this diorama cardboard cutout. You can see right here, it has a picture of Hell's Kitchen with the Daredevil logo. I'm probably not going to use this, but I think it would look great if you have a detolf and have this maybe behind the diorama base. I think it will look really good. Some of these don't look that good, but I actually like the way that this one looks. My display just wouldn't look good if I had just the one figure in it with this, with the backdrop, and then the rest with not. So you do have the option to use this backdrop as well if you want to use it. So let's go ahead and jump into the actual figure. So with the figure, we'll take a look at the head first. Let's go ahead and get that camera to focus. So you do get the cowl with it. I think they did a really great job with the cowl. You can kind of see the detail, the likeness of them within the nose. You have some pretty good jawline here, and they did a great job with the lips and the mouth. You also get some stubble here across the face. Camera's not picking it up too good, but the paint applications on this I think are pretty nice. I think they could have made it a little bit darker just to kind of made it a little bit more prominent, but other than that, they did a pretty decent job with it. You also get two face plates. So the one I currently have on him right now is the bloodied version, and then you also get a clean version of this as well. All right, so if you want to actually remove the cowl and change out the faceplate, this is a little bit different. What you do is pop off the top of the cowl here. You have a connection right there that will fit right here. And then this piece just pulls right off. And then you can place this one in. And then put the cowl right back on top to get the other faceplate in there. The cowl looks great. You have some great texturing right inside here along the back as well. Some great sculpting right here on the top of the cowl. The best thing I like about this thing too is that there's no real seam. The way that they designed this thing with popping off this, I thought you would think you'd see like some sort of seam, but it actually pretty seamless and flows really nicely between the figure. Also cool little feature right here is the red eyes like he has in the movie. One thing I would have liked for this is maybe get an unmasked portrait of the figure as well. I probably wouldn't even use it, but it would just have been a cool option to have that with the figure. As for the paint applications, they did a great job on the skin tone. They have both pretty cohesive throughout both of them. You also get a pretty good detail here sculpting within the teeth there. Looks really nice. And then I love the way that they did the blood with this one. You have a transparent to dark, and you have some of that skin tone seeping through some of that transparent blood there. So as for the suit looks absolutely fantastic. You have a red and black color variation. The suit is tight fitting with a leather like material on it. Fits really great, but I am worried there might be some issues with articulation once we start getting into the posing, just because it is pretty tight fitting on it. Everything on here looks pretty great. The suit is tight fitting. This part looks a little bit weird down here. You have tight fitting everywhere with a little bit loose down there. I don't know if that was intentional just to get some more leg movement out of it. One thing I would keep an eye out too is when you are moving this guy, you get some wrinkling around the leg area. So just be mindful what kind of poses and stuff you actually put this guy in, so because you don't want to damage the suit. You do get the two-tone again, like the black and the red, which looks absolutely fantastic. Everything on here looks great. You get the harder shoulder pads right here, which are a bit plastic. It separates the leather. And then as for the boots, you do get two separated boots, which is I actually think is really nice. It's going to help with articulation. So you get some pretty good movement out of both just because of the separated boots. And then you have the sculpted laces that are right inside here. As for articulation, like I said, the suit is pretty tight. So you do get some restriction here in the shoulders just because of how tight it is. As for the arms and the elbows, no restriction there. Pretty good movement. Obviously, you're going to get some pretty good movement out of the hands. Head sculpt is a little bit restricted, but you do get some movement up and down. Sideways, actually, the joints were just a little bit tight on mine, but so you do have no restrictions on the head there. And like I said, with the legs, you do get that bunch up right here, so I would be careful on when you pose it. Other than that, you have pretty good movement throughout the leg, and the knee looks pretty good as well. Like I said, the boots are sculpted in two pieces, so you're going to be able to get pretty good articulation throughout the entire piece here. All right, guys, so I'm excited to get this guy posed up. We're going to go ahead and jump into the posing section and see what kind of poses we can get out of it. Thank you guys all so much for watching today's review. I hope you guys enjoyed the review of the Daredevil 6-scale figure by Hot Toys. If you guys have this figure or are interested in picking this up, let me know in the comments down below. This is a phenomenal figure. I'm glad to add it to the collection. Again, I hope you guys all enjoyed it, and I'll see you guys all in the next video.